the tone that has been set by universities. And my belief again would be we've passed the days whereby universities were ivory towers. I think now the doors of learning and culture has been open to all, but the issue of access still remains a challenge. So the way we used to do things in the past has to change. We need to accept that students are made as they could, and they are young adults, they cannot be treated like children. In doing so, constructive engagement and real communication remain a vital point to resolve our problems, even before we resolve to close, because universities use their strength to go to court and get a court order, and students use their strength to close gates. So I think that approach, it has not assisted anyone. Why will I refuse to engage students when eventually at the end of the day, we have to sit down and resolve problems? All strikes have been resolved by a round table. That's why you're able to go back to classes. My belief is you don't even need to start by a strike. You need to start at a round table. And that's how I believe. And round table discussions must not just be talk shop. And again, the issue of archives in the side of student leadership remain a problem. I also believe conference like this one remain important, so that when the new SRC take over, there must be a smooth handover to know what are the issues that were resolved in by the current SRC, and what issues that the incoming SRC must deal with them. And I've said this to those I'm close with in council, but in my capacity as Pilan, and I was talking to them in my capacity, in their capacity as my friends. So I'm from Baba Atek. I've said to them, the TUT must budget for the, what do you call this thing, a slow sailing knife on this one. It's a shortfall from NFSAS. You know that the NFSAS, maybe, you are anticipating that it's going to give us 5 million, but they ended up giving us 4 million. So TUT must budget for that 1 million because we know that there's going to be a shortfall. If there's a surplus, it's still a bonus on us. I'm saying that to those who are in council, but now, moving towards the future, let the university budget so that we don't even find a necessity to strike. And I think university has not used AMA merit bursaries to the fullness of students, to the benefit of all students. I was asking myself, a student with a passing rate of 96% is using NFSAS. I was saying it does not make sense. And I also believe with the university, the tracking system is very weak. We're able to track students who are not performing academically and exclude them, but we're unable to track students who are excelling academically and refer them to financial aid for financial support. Yes. So I also believe the university is failing on that regard. I also believe that university, corporate affairs, I'm not attacking corporate affairs. They are my buddies, you know, I depend on them for everything. You guys, you know, I can't attack them. I must protect them. Otherwise, I'm not going to get t-shirts. But I believe, Uti, we need to strengthen our corporate affairs. If you look, after 18 cars were banned, there was no voice from TUT. Again, if you observe, MJ is an expert in this field. I think he will concur with me. If you notice, after a student was killed at Social Move, again, there was no voice from TUT. After the strike this year, I don't think we have a communication. We have a crisis communication plan. And again, if you look at the spokespersons of the university, they are very good. You must appreciate that. But you must change. You must look at the society. They normally address Radio 702. Most of you, your parents, will find that Bakuma is their bed, Bamela Ikwekwes, Bamamela Ukos, Bamamela Ntwedin. So we need people who can speak that lingo is Tswana, so that even parents at home, they can hear what is the progress, what is happening. And again, you must not communicate things that has not yet been agreed upon and say tomorrow is business as usual. And the university is totally Guvarama gate again. That's all. Strategically, you rather reserve your comment until you know what is the next move. That is my belief. But I also believe that on the side of the student leadership, strike is not a strategy. It's a tactic that you use to pursue your strategy. Explore all communication channels and learn to elect leaders. You can have a 55% but not have a leadership capacity. These are two different things. You can have leadership capacity and not have 55%. Learn to elect leaders, leaders who can lead by example, not populist. And again, I think university and our political structures have a responsibility to revisit the recall clause.